Hi children, welcome to this English video class. How are you children? I hope that all are safe at your home. This is Sirisha, your English teacher. Children, in our last class, we learned some textual exercises. Okay children? So now in this class, we learn our punctuative given passes in our textbook and punctuation marks also. Okay children? Now let us start, get ready. So children, our given passes in your textbook is Mother, Father, Neelam said, I have got a fire engine, I have got a fire engine, what's this, called Mother, somewhat confused by the noise, I have got a fire engine, Mother, come and see it. Okay children, this is our passes. When we observe these passes, there is no full stop, comma, or any question mark also. So without this or, this is just a group of words but does not convey any proper thought. Now what is our work children? Our work is putting punctuations in required place in these passes. Okay children, but first of all we learn about punctuation marks. After that we will do our textbook exercise. Okay children, now let us go to our punctuation marks. Children, look at this following example. So here, open quotation marks, allow baking, comma, my family, comma, and my friends, and then closer quotation marks. Okay, children? So, what is the meaning of this sentence? Allow baking, allow my family, and allow my friends also. Okay, children? Now, we remove these commas in this example. Okay. Then this sentence is turned into a quotation marks, allow baking, my family and my friends, and then closer quotation marks. Okay children. Now what happened children? When we remove these commas, then totally meaning of this sentence is changed. Because the meaning of sentence is allowed to bake my friends and my family. Okay children? So when we remove these commas from the first sentence, then it represents allow baking my family and my friends. That means allowed to bake my friends and my family. Okay children? So here observe small difference in between these two sentence children. First one represents allow my family and allow my friends. But when we remove these commas, the second sentence represents allow to bake my family and my friends. How funny this is children. So punctuation marks are very very important in English writing children. This is the little example to importance of punctuation marks. Okay children, now let us see what are the punctuation marks and different types of punctuation marks. Okay children, so punctuation marks used in writing to separate parts of sentences and make the meaning clear. Okay, punctuation marks used in writing to separate parts of sentences and make the meaning clear. Now let us see punctuation marks one by one. Okay children, our first one is capital letter and full stop. Capital letter and full stop. Children, look at this following example children. The girl is playing cricket. The girl is playing cricket. Children, you notice the begin and end of the sentence. Here the THD word is start with a capital letter T. Okay, capital letter T because it is the first word in this sentence. And next, the sentence ends with a full stop. Ends with a full stop because it is clearly what the girl is doing now. Okay children, so here first word, they start with a capital letter and the sentence end with a full stop. So children, remember one point. A sentence begins with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. Okay children, a sentence always begins with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. Okay, our next one is pronoun. Here the pronoun I is written in a capital letter wherever it appears. Okay children, the pronoun I is written in a capital letter wherever it appears. Okay, now look at this example children. Neha and I are sisters. Neha and I are sisters. Children, in this example we use capital letter I because here I is a pronoun, that's why we use capital letter I. Remember this point also children, wherever you see I, then you write a capital letter I. Okay children, now let us go to our next punctuation marks, that is the proper noun. Okay children, proper noun. A proper noun always begins with a capital letter. A proper noun always begins with a capital letter. Children, what is a proper noun? What is a proper noun children? Proper noun means it is a specific name for a particular person, place or thing or companies or days of the week. Okay, so proper nouns are always capitalized in English. Okay children, some examples for proper noun are Sita, Geeta, Ramu, Chotu, and these are examples for particular persons. And Delhi, New York, Bombay, Madras, Calcutta. So these are names of the particular places. Okay, and also we use a capital letter for the names of persons, places, companies, days of the week and months also. Okay children, now let us see our examples. Our first example is she gave a pen to Raju. She gave a pen to Raju. In this sentence, the word Raju started with a capital letter because Raju is a proper noun, because it is a particular person's name. That's why we use capital letter in this word. Okay children, so that means proper noun always begins with a capital letter. Okay children, next, what is our second example? In every week, Sunday is a holiday. Okay children, in every week, Sunday is a holiday. Here, Sunday is a proper noun because it is the days of the week. Okay children, that's why we use capital letter in Sunday. So children, every time, a proper noun always begins with a capital letter. Okay children, don't forget this point. Now, let us go to our next punctuation mark, that is question mark. Okay children, so here look at this following examples children. What are you doing? Okay, how old are you? What are you doing? How old are you? These are the questions. Notice the symbol used at the end of a sentence. Okay, notice the symbol end of sentence. It is called a question mark. It is called a question mark. So children, a sentence that asks a question ends with a question mark. A sentence that asks a question ends with a question mark. Okay children, so every time question ends with a question mark. What are you doing? How old are you? What is it? Okay, so these are all questions. A sentence that asks a question ends with a question mark. Next, what is our next punctuation mark? Comma. Okay, so our next punctuation mark is comma. Look at this following sentence. First one is, my favorite fruits are apple and banana. My favorite fruits are apple and banana. Here there are only two items. These are apple and banana. Okay children, now look at this another sentence. My favorite fruits are apple, banana and mango. My favorite fruits are apple, banana and mango. Here more than two items in this list. So here we use a comma for separate it. Okay children, here more than two items because here apple, banana and mango are there. That's why we use commas here. So comma is used to separate three or more words in a list. Comma is used to separate three or more words in a list. Okay, children? And also the next one is comma is also used often in introductory words such as yes, no, hi, hello, etc. Comma is also used often in introductory words such as yes, no, hi, hello, etc. Okay, children? Look at this over example. Hello, comma, what are you doing? Question mark. Okay, children? Here, hello is an introductory word. That's why we use a comma after this introductory word. Then, what are you doing? Because this is a question mark. That's why at the end of the sentence, we put a question mark. Okay, children? So, comma is used to separate three or more words in a list. And it is also used often in introductory words such as yes, no, hi, hello, etc. Okay, children? And also the comma is also used for giving a short pause in a sentence. Comma is also used for giving a short pause in a sentence. Okay, children? What means by pause? What is the meaning of pause? So, pause means temporary stop in a speech. Temporary stop in speech. Look at this following example, children. Every Sunday, I go for a walk, comma, have breakfast, comma, read storybooks and watch television. Okay, children? So, here, commas, every Sunday, I go for a walk, have breakfast, read storybooks and watch television. Okay, children? So, these commas are separate these small sentences. That means, comma is used for giving a short pauses in your sentences. Okay, children? Now, let us go to our next punctuation mark. That is, exclamation mark. We use exclamation mark at the end of a word or a sentence to show strong feelings such as surprise, anger or joy. Okay, children? Children, when we speak, we often use our voices and body movements to show our feelings. That means here feelings such as anger, fear, happiness, surprise, excitement, etc. But how to express our feelings in writing? So, in writing, exclamation mark can be used to show our feelings. That means surprise, fear, happiness, our excitement, etc. So, exclamation mark is used to at the end of a word or a sentence to show strong feelings such as surprise, anger or joy. Okay, children? Look at this following example, children. What a beautiful flower. What a beautiful flower. So, this sentence represents our surprise and happiness. What a beautiful flower. Okay? Next one, shut up. So, this represents anger feeling. This sentence shows anger feeling. Shut up. This shows anger feeling. Okay, children? So, exclamation mark is used for express our strong feelings such as surprise, anger or joy in writing. Okay, children? Now, let us go to our next punctuation mark, apostrophe. Okay, children? Apostrophe. So, here, apostrophe is used to form contractions or to indicate position. Okay, children? So, here, apostrophe is used to form contractions or to indicate position. So, what is the position? Position means something that is owned or possessed. Something that is owned or possessed. That means something having. Okay, something having or something belonging. Something belonging. Look at this example, children. The girl's dog is so cute. Children, here observe apostrophe after L. Okay, the girl's dog is so cute. So this sentence represents the dog belonging to a girl. The dog belonging to a girl. Okay, children. Next one. This bike is Raghu's bike. This bike is Raghu's bike. So here, this bike is Raghu's bike means this bike belonging to Raghu. Okay, children. This bike belonging to Raghu. So apostrophe said that belongs to whom or someone. Apostrophe said that something that belongs to whom or someone. Okay, and its position is upstairs. And its position is upstairs in a sentence. Okay, children. So apostrophe can be used to indicate possession. Possession means something that is owned or possessed. That means something having or something belonging to whom. Okay, next one. And apostrophe is also used for a contraction is a shortened word made by putting two words together. That means apostrophe is also used to make contraction words. A contraction is a shortened word made by putting two words together. Okay, children. Observe these following examples, children. For example, our first one is you plus or can be said as your. You plus or can be said as your. Okay. So when we observe this one, so here you plus or combined then form your. So here apostrophe shows one or more letters have been taken out. Okay, children, when we observe this example you plus or equal to your, in this example a has been taken out. So here apostrophe represents missing letters. Okay, children. So our next examples are that plus is can be said as that's. I plus have can be said as I've. I plus would can be said as I'd. It plus is can be said as it's. What plus is can be said as what's. We plus will can be said as we. Okay, children. So apostrophe is used to indicate possession. This is the first one. Second one is, and it is form contraction words also. How to contraction word form? A contraction is a shortened word made by putting two words together. Okay, children. You plus or your, that plus is that's, I plus have I plus would I'd, it plus is it's, what plus is what's, we plus will we. Okay, children. And also this apostrophe shows where one or more letter have been taken out. That means it shows missing letters in contraction word. Okay, children. And also it is used for some contractions are formed by putting a verb with the word not. Some contractions are formed by putting a verb with the word not. Okay, children. So look at these following examples. Can plus not, can't. Can plus not can be said as can't. Is plus not can be said as isn't. Do plus not, don't. Did plus not, didn't. Would plus not, wouldn't. Or plus not, aren't. Were plus not, weren't. Okay, children. Here also apostrophe represents one or more letter have been taken out. That means it shows missing letters in a contraction word. Okay, children. So totally apostrophe is used to indicate possession and to form contraction words. Okay, children. Now let us go to our next punctuation marks, that is the quotation marks or speech marks or double inverted commas. Okay, children. So here quotation marks or speech marks that show the exact word of a speaker. That show the exact word of a speaker. Children, look at this second point. Here these are called open quotation marks, open quotation marks, quote or the exact words, quote or the exact words, then full stop, closer quotation marks. Okay children, so this means exact words are placed inside the open quotation marks and the closer quotation marks. Okay children, exact words are placed inside the open quotation marks and closer quotation marks. Look at this following examples children. The doctor asked, the doctor asked, next comma, open quotation marks, how do you feel today, question mark, and ends with the closer quotation mark. Okay children, next another example is Akbar asked Birbal, okay comma, next open quotation marks, how did you find the truth, question mark, and closer quotation marks. Okay, when we take the first example, in this example the doctor asked how do you feel today. In this example, who said how do you feel today children? The doctor said. So these are exact words because here doctor is a speaker, that's why how do you feel today, these are exact words. So here a comma separate these exact words from the rest of the sentence. Okay children, so here a comma separate the exact words, that means how do you feel today, these are separates from the rest of the sentence, and it is begins with the capital letter H. That means exact words, that means first word in a exact word start with a capital letter. Okay children, and end with the question mark, because this is a question, because the doctor asked here, that's why this is a question. So it is ends with the question mark before the closer quotation mark. Okay children, so when we use speech marks or quotation marks or double inverted commas, remember two points. These are a comma to separate the exact words from the rest of the sentence, and always write a capital letter in the first word of the exact word. Okay children, and put the end with the punctuation mark before the closer quotation marks, and put the end with the punctuation mark, that is question mark or exclamation mark or full stop, anyone, put the end with the punctuation mark before the closer quotation marks. Okay children, so these are our punctuation marks. So in this class we learn capital letter, okay, capital letter and full stop. Next we learn pronoun. Next we learn, first of all we learn capital letter and full stop. So a sentence begins with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. Next we learn about pronoun. We learn pronoun. So here the pronoun I is written in a capital letter wherever it appears. Next we learned proper noun. A proper noun always begins with a capital letter. Okay. Next we learned question mark. Okay. A sentence that asks a question ends with a question mark. Next we learned comma. Comma is used to separate three or more words in a list, and it is also used after in introductory words such as yes, no, hi, hello, etc. And it is also used for giving a short pause in a sentence. Okay children, next we learned exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. Okay children, so observe exclamation mark in these brackets, so standing line on small dot. Okay, so we use exclamation mark at the end of a word or a sentence to show strong feelings such as surprise, anger, or joy. Okay children, next we learned apostrophe. Apostrophe is used to indicate position and made contraction words also. A contraction word is a shortened word made by putting two words together. Okay children, and apostrophe place is upstairs. Okay, children. Next one. And some contractions are formed by putting a verb with the word not. Can plus not, can't. Here, apostrophe represents one or more letters have been taken out from this word. Next, will and question marks or speech marks or double inverted commas. Okay, so here question mark, quotation marks or speech marks represent show the exact word of a speaker. Exact word of a speaker. Always exact words are inside the place of open quotation marks and closed quotation marks. Okay, children. So here a comma separate the exact words from the rest of the sentence. And started with a capital letter and end with a question mark or full stop or exclamation mark. That is the punctuation mark. And then end with closer quotation marks. Okay, children. So these are our punctuation marks, children. I hope all are understand what are punctuation marks, how to use these punctuation marks. Okay, children. In our next class, we'll learn how to put punctuations in our textbook passages. Okay, children.